Christopher Neil.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Press on. Press harder. Press now. We got gang activity. South Holland Police. Car number 7 and 11. Go ahead. How are you doing?
Good. I see you.
How far?
That's fine.
Okay, what if I take one step closer? Okay, I'll go back.
Seriously, you want it?
Watch it in slow motion as you turn.
I'm one of the people. Welcome to the hill where we have the proper perspective to press on, press harder, press now.
Right?
Aw, this episode, we're flying into hostile territory and dropping bombs. Oh yeah, fuck yeah. But sadly, unlike in everyone's favorite number one movie of all time, Chappy isn't getting picked up by an Egyptian trawler. He's really gone. So this video is dedicated to Chappy.
Mayday! Mayday!
Chappy! Chappy, where are you?
Just put in that tape. That's an order. Nothing you can do about me.
Chappy, I want to help you. Where are you?
Climb high like I told you. Doug, I ain't gonna make it.
Chappy!
A bunch of things must have gone wrong if you're listening to this. Whatever happened, I know you must be real scared. I wouldn't blame you if you wanted to head for home. Maybe if I was you, I'd want to make a flat-out run for Helicon Air Force Base in Greece. Right now, you're probably filled with all the doubts in the world. But I'm going to tell you something, Doug, baby. God doesn't give people things he doesn't want them to use. And he gave you the touch. It's a power you have inside of you, down there where you keep your guts, boy. And it's all you need to blast your way in and get back what they took from you. Your dad's just sitting there waiting for a miracle. And if you fly your heart out, you can give him one. It's up to you. Don't bother putting on this tape if you turn him back. Good. You decided, didn't you? All right. First thing you gotta do is convince yourself that nothing can stop you. You gotta believe that plane you're in is like a suit of armor, like an iron eagle that nothing can penetrate. Now listen close, kid. I recorded some stuff to help you through each part of the mission. Remember to talk into your flight recorder so there's a record of everything. Don't waste your time worrying about me. You start thinking that way and you'll mess up. Just pretend I'm in that cockpit with you, and we're still going in to knock the shit out of them together.
Never say die, I am eagle, nothing forever, now or never. Never say die, I am eagle, never look back, never say die.
Get
up to 60% off at Michael's Easter sale. Grab Easter finds starting at 99 cents with all Easter on sale. Score crafts for kids' Easter baskets. Plus, up to 60% off spring decor and floral. Shop frames, and here's another way to save.
On this episode, we're putting a 420 in the chat if you just tried to pass over that unpaid Easter ad. Like the cops give up freedom for Lent, only to find out the skip button is broken. For fuck's sake. And on top of that, I left an Easter egg for all of you a while back on my good buddy Christo the Great, otherwise known as Jersey Watchers live stream. But just in case you didn't see, it's been resurrected today in color.
I press on, I press harder, I press now. And since we're talking about this, I might as well just break the news. There's also a press on channel. And the first video on that will premiere on April 8th.
So we're going to go full circle.
And we'll get to see the kidnapping that nobody's seen yet. Nobody knows where it happened, but I was kidnapped last year, and I went 34 days without eating any food. And then they had to tase me twice to get me to leave.
Wow.
Nobody's ever seen that, but we'll be premiering that video on Press On. And Press On, you know, like I said, press harder is for protests, and press now is for conversations, but press on is about good old boys and good old girls just trying to make their way, and that's just a little bit more than the law will allow.
Listen up, just a good old boy, never meaning no harm. Beats all you ever saw, been in trouble with the law since the day they was born. Straightening the curves, riding the hills. Someday the mountain might get them, but the law never will. Making their way. Just a little bit more than the law will allow.
All right. I love it. I've always been a fan of yours.
So press on, folks. Press harder and press now.
And now, the intro you've all been waiting for. With a floppy ears and a big carrot, it's time for the bunny! And the crowd is ecstatic to sacrifice a pig and ham it up as we hold mass over another cop's shriveled up jelly beans while dying his little rotten ass eggs and making him repent for all the peeps and all the baskets with a hippity hop as a cop watches the people ascend atop and spring forward with this Illinois state trooper that BSBT and I detained and forced to watch our Sunday roast.
What's your name?
Sergeant Skinner.
Sergeant Skinner.
Off
nice
duty.
To meet you.
My name is Larry Skinner. Nice to meet you.
Larry. Yeah,
I was born
yeah.
and raised in West Englewood, 61st and Hermitage, one of the worst neighborhoods in.
I don't Far. Know if you'll be able to see it.
Yeah, so you stop.
Okay. What if I take one step closer? Okay, I'll go back.
Yeah, you follow. You're following the commands, he's the directives he's giving. Okay. Just walk.
You know I didn't have to.
Yeah,
you know
yeah,
what I mean.
Yeah.
Watch it in slow motion as you turn around and say, That's funny. I like the. Oh, wow.
It goes on though. Hold on. It's not a very long video.
Yeah.
And then we'll let you go, man. This is a good ending right here. Yeah.
Thank you. I'm ready to go.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's your initial approach right here.
That's my. We were both. Yeah, press. The second part is me walking up to him.
We got gang activity.
I'm not Brad.
Oh, well. Car number 7 and 11.
Right.
But how are you doing?
Good. So you're going to do the same thing, huh?
What's the same thing?
The next car traffic stop.
Is this still a public sidewalk?
It looks like a public sidewalk to me.
Yeah.
Right? You see what I'm saying?
We're
in a public sidewalk. So yeah. Yeah, I mean.
You've been so pleasant to deal with,
no
man.
No problem, bro.
Thank you.
You know what? I might even add that reaction in.
Yeah. Oh, we're definitely going to add that reaction.
Go ahead.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Stay back to our traffic stop.
Is this still a public sidewalk?
Stay back to our traffic stop. Otherwise, it's considered.
Is this still a public sidewalk? Where's your traffic stop begin and end?
Sir, step off into the parking lot. Don't go there.
This is a public sidewalk.
Keep walking then.
Why? What law am I breaking?
Move along.
Move along.
Move along.
To where?
Look,
to where? Bullshit.
Stay back. Stay back.
I'm back. No, you don't have to worry about us. You don't have to worry about anybody that's not breaking the law.
It looks like a public sidewalk to me.
You know, we're not, listen, man, nobody here is a threat to you, man. This thing is not a threat to you. It's just a camera.
Sir?
It's just a camera. Can you say that for the camera one more time, please? He said there are guns that look like cameras. So you fear for your safety right now. Are you going to convince me? You're afraid for your safety right now. What a fucking scaredy cat. Afraid for safety because cameras are here.
Don't interfere.
What do you, hey, how do you define interference?
This action right now
is interference, so you're going to arrest me right now.
Nope.
No? Oh, so I'm not interfering.
You are.
I am or I'm not? Which one is it, sir? I am. What's your name and badge number, man? Hey, what is... What's your name and badge number? Yeah, go ahead and zoom in.
That's Officer Layden.
Yeah, just don't
Layden.
Officer Layden.
Okay. Thank you. L-A-D-E-N?
L-A-L-E-Y-D-N.
He didn't want to give me his name and badge number.
It's not a secret. It's not a secret.
Right here,
it shouldn't be.
It's not a secret.
It shouldn't be. But like in this case...
super cool, right?
Yeah. Super cool.
Why wouldn't we be?
Why? That's what I'm saying. Why wouldn't you be?
That's what I wanted to know from him.
But he had a reason.
I got no reason not to be.
Yeah, we were, I guess, on the other side of Starbucks. Oh, are you busy?
No,
okay.
My business card.
Oh, hell yeah. Awesome. Those are good to roll joints with.
There you go. Only purchased legally at a legal dispensary.
Of course.
Yeah. Illinois gets their tax revenue.
Yeah.
I totally understand.
We'll go with that story.
You guys got a YouTube channel or anything?
Oh, we've got things.
Smolinski.
Yeah, me. Yeah. Smolinski. I like it.
No, he was actually in a parking lot, not even on the sidewalk, and he immediately told him he was interfering. Immediately.
Walking past him.
Right? Like, boom. And then I walked by on the sidewalk and messed up his whole day. He didn't see me coming.
Well, my day was messed up long for you.
No, but he was going...
My day was long messed up.
No, but he was... Okay. He was, like, in the parking lot, right? And Layden was here, like, leaned up against the car, right? And then he's telling him to move back, and he's in the parking lot, okay, telling him he's interfering. And then he never sees me coming walking up the sidewalk, right? And so I'm walking up the sidewalk, and he jumps in front of me to go after him, and then now I'm in between Layden and the cop car, and he, like, spins around in this huge circle and stuff. His head explodes.
Yeah, I don't want to pass judgment because I wasn't there, but maybe he was having a bad day or something. He's usually a pretty nice guy.
But, I mean, the thing is, you should know this is a public sidewalk. It's not closed just because you do a traffic stop. If you want to put tape up or whatever and close it, then that means the road's open.
It's our job to provide the... If it's restricted, we need to provide it to the general public.
Yeah. Yeah. But if you did close this sidewalk, then the road is now my sidewalk.
It's the most accessible place.
Yeah. Like, he can't make us go into public.
If it's not available, then you use privilege.
Right. But, I mean, that's there, but that's private property. Right? You get it.
Yeah.
Yeah. If officers acted like you, like, nobody would be filming.
I don't mind being filmed.
You shouldn't.
I had my last video that they did got over 4 million views. Some lady at Starbucks was making a stink, and they wanted her out because it's private property, and she was recording and sleeping in there. Well, I was really kind to her. And I can't remember the site that it was on, but it got like 4.5 million views. And this officer was really good. You see that one?
The lady filmed it herself?
Yeah. She was filming on her iPad. I'm not filming it, she's holding an iPad. Like, okay. Maybe you're not filming.
Smolensky, right? I don't mean to put a damper on your viral video, but I got a video of a guy kicking a fish.
A cop kicking a fish?
40 million.
40 million?
40
million. Why would you kick a fish?
No, there was a fish in the road, like it had flooded, and like a fish got in the road, and he's like trying to kick it and kick it all the way into the...
Just lift the poor thing.
What I said.
He's never been fishing before. You know what I mean?
Never been fishing. Yeah, we just had a nice conversation with that state. You can barely see his car parked in the...
He's actually a resident somehow.
Oh, yeah? Inglewood Rambo. On social media.
He actually is a resident of South Island here. Every morning I see him at the BP. I say hello every morning. I get my beverage. He gets his.
Oh, yeah? He's a nice guy. All right.
And tag me if you tag me, Inglewood Rambo.
Inglewood Rambo. That's hell me. Yeah. Yeah, we had a nice conversation with him.
I wouldn't want to be in his bad side. I'll tell you that.
No, he's built like a brick shithouse, man.
He's bigger than my thighs.
I wouldn't want to be in that guy's bad side. By all means. Absolutely not.
Yeah.
Right? I wouldn't want to get in between him and his energy drink.
Yeah,
either. Yeah. You want to talk, Deputy Chief?
Yeah.
How are you doing today?
Okay. What can I help you with?
Well, stand a little bit back. Okay. We've filmed several traffic stops in town, and it's not that. That's not really the problem. But some of your officers think they don't have to identify.
Okay.
Which is a big problem.
True. Right.
To anyone that asks, anytime.
Who are they identifying with?
If somebody asks them, and a police officer, who they are, like what their name is, they're required to give their name and their badge number if requested. You know what I mean? And it's just,
what is your interaction with them?
It doesn't matter.
I
said I'm filming traffic stops, right? But after the traffic stop is over, not during it, right? Like, we've asked several officers.
Are you talking to them while they're conducting?
No, not talking to them while they're conducting the traffic stop. No, unless they say something to us, right? And that brings me to the second point, is that some of your officers, Leiden, L-E-Y-D-E-N, and Chavez, are not briefed on what a public sidewalk is, right? That's public.
Okay.
So just because you do a traffic stop doesn't mean that everything's closed.
Okay.
Right?
Well,
I mean, if it's closed, it's closed.
Well, what are you getting at with this? Is that
jive turkey?
Do you want me to speak with them in reference?
Yeah, I'm sure you already know that we've been filming. We already know that you guys have been talking about it, which is good. We want you guys to, you know and not be scared. Like, we're not a threat or anything like that.
Yeah, I don't perceive you as a threat.
You know what I mean? Are you guys talking about us?
Yes.
You are, right? Good. Because we're starting to get worried that, like, the message is not spreading.
Yeah, we're like, the message hasn't spread yet. Okay.
Yeah, like filming is okay. Right. You know what I mean?
You don't have to answer. Were you guys at Kinley Park at all?
Kinley Park?
Is that a post office?
No.
Because okay. I was on the SWAT team for 7 years. As a multi-jurisdictional team, there's like 36 agencies that are on the team. So I've got friends all over at all different departments. And I just asked, hey, has anybody else seen these guys? They're here for a couple days and they kind of disappear. They come back and they disappear. So I'm guessing they're working their way around, which obviously is out. And a buddy, Kinley, responded. He's like, I think they were at our post office too long, and our guys went viral from them. So if it was you guys.
Yeah,
it wasn't.
Post office.
We don't really do audits.
Yeah, that's what they call like an audit in the YouTube world. Yeah. And
we're all for them, but we don't really do them. We film traffic stops usually. Well, I usually would never even go to a government building. It's just that it's right there by Starbucks. And there's all this national news, you know what I mean? Yeah. So we went over and sat in Queen Tip's chair. Oh, man, they were so furious. We sat in her chair.
I sat in the city attorney's chair, which is probably a lot more appropriate for me.
We filmed about 20 stops in just 12 days. That's an awful lot of traffic stops going on in this town.
Okay.
But aside from that, a couple of them have gotten really scary. Right where officers are telling us that we're interfering just for standing on a public sidewalk.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying? And that's not interfering.
Okay.
Right. One time, I mean, I was ordered to go into private property, which you have no authority to order me onto private property.
Okay.
Right. If the sidewalk is closed and the road is open, and then then I can walk in the road.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying? So from an officer's standpoint, it doesn't make any sense to close the sidewalk and leave the road open, because then there's no sidewalk, which means you can walk in the road. Wherever there's not a sidewalk, you can walk in the roadway. Right? That's Illinois law.
Okay. So
am I right on that?
So well,
I mean, I just think you should have a talk with them.
I mean, like private property. So like if you're talking a bank, would it be smart to walk in the roadway if the street was closed, or walk through the bank's parking lot to get around that area?
Maybe I could walk in the bank, but an officer can't order me into the bank. They don't know if I'm trespassed from there. It's not their property. There's public property.
Okay.
Right. A sidewalk is for the public.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying? That's where they're allowed to be.
Okay.
If you have a traffic stop on the road next to the sidewalk, well, traffic stops don't warrant the closure of a sidewalk. But if you are going to close the sidewalk, you got to close it to everybody.
Okay.
Right?
Well, I mean, there's everything situational. So.
Okay. So.
No, it's not situational. You can't just close it to one person and leave it open for somebody else.
Are you making statements to me, or are you asking me?
I'm making you aware of the situation, right? That you have some officers that don't know what public property is.
Yeah, she's professional. Nice braids, baby. Nice braids. Loving them. Loving it. It seems like she was able to do her duty just fine. Yeah, you're badass, baby. Loving it.
Lighting?
Yeah.
L-E-Y-D-E-N? Yeah. Lyden.
Okay.
Man, see, he's got the word lie in his name, right? that says a lot, you know?
Have you ever had any acorns drop on your scene? You know about that.
Okay.
You're the first cop that's admitted to even knowing about it, which we find very suspect.
As a department, you mean?
A double mag dump.
As a department, wow.
Double mag dump. Yeah. Press on, press harder, press now.
Obey your master. Master.
三民主义好，一些大小官员都是公仆，一些贪官污吏统统打倒，无声。
So press on, folks. Press harder and press now.
For years, the servants have been smoking crack and going commando with little units, blue line panties, and trigger fingers. Today, still wanted by the government, with a more perfect union, a people serving. die. If you're ready to press, the Constitution will help. But if you can find it, and you can afford it, maybe you can get the people. Together. Oh,